with their own tribe, with their own tribe, with their own, with their own cons. This just ain't across the drop desk. Remember to breathe. We're going to breathe our way through this one, man. Breathing is important. Very, very important. I mean, it's the breath. It's the fifth letter of the Hebrew. It's the revelation. So when you take your breath, remember it's existent. Don't take your breath in vain. Don't take the name in vain. That's part of our code. Your breath, your security is wah. Wah. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, feminine. Exhale, masculine. That's your balance, frame, or shaper. Wow. Sometimes when you're running, or you know, you even practice trying to breathe through your nose and mouth at the same time. I mean, in terms of inhaling through your nose and mouth at the same time, kind of a running, you know, breathing trick they do. You know, I'm just all into breathing, man. Shout out to Hicks and Gracie, man. Great jiu-jitsu artist teaching all this breathing techniques as well. You know what I mean? Just keep learning breathing. You know, keep mastering your breath. You know, your diaphragm. Your breath should be horizontal, not so much vertical. You know, it shouldn't be breathing out your chest all the time. Use your diaphragm. That's that horizontal breathing. It's going straight, right? Your belly button should be going straight out. Fill in your diaphragm. And before you want to gain your breath, you need to do a good exhale to get out all that bad breath, all that extra lagging breath in there. So you might be tempted to breathe, you know, to inhale first, you know, but exhale first. Get that bad air out first. Get the bad air out. It's going to give you more lung capacity, man. I'm just talking about, wow, we can't talk a while and not talk breath around here. So let's... Wow. One more time, my niggas. Wow. That's that breath. That's that security. With they all try, with they all. Shout out to my con and my nigga Big Savage on IG by way of trending. Was it man? Trending Truths. Trending Truths, man. Shout out to Trending Truths. It's a lot. I mean, this is just a lot, man. You know, these are some coordinates they dropped on IG. I said, nah, man. This is crazy, dog. We in California, man. Let me back up. We in Cali. All right. Keep going. Let's make it clear. There we go. Okay. Now it's clear. We in California. You know, and same road I took just going to New Mexico. Very close, you know, off this 10 here before it goes into the 40. A couple ways to drive out east. It's pretty amazing stuff, man. I just want to know what they all try. I'm not here to speculate. I'm just here to say, what the fees? We're just going to have a what the feesy moment about that. What the feesy? Well, I mean, look. It's a lie. Just look at this, you know, desert. And I put different marks all over the place. I was like, what is this? What is that? What is this? What is this? I mean, Google Earth. I'll drop the link, man. Y'all, I just want to know, Drop Nation, you the reconners. You the reconners, man. The con Big Savage dropped it on me. I never seen nothing like this. He said, is this a portal? Is this not just getting in and out? I mean, they seem to be guarding it with a bunch of tanks. And this is, you know, what Trending Truths was dropping on as well. So I'm going to take my time and hit up all these marks. First of all, I'm just going to come right in on the high strangeness. High strangeness. Say it with me, Manani. What the fizzy? Don't say this is normal, boss. Don't say there's a bunch of these popping up. Don't say this is just a natural phenomena. This looks, I mean, look how symmetric, you know, this is going on, man. Clearly man-made, clearly built, or some type of portal opening up. Seems to be another type of situation under the dirt here. You know, most of the stuff in the desert is going to be underground, so very little, you know, you're going to catch, you know, overground, so to speak. You know, I'm going to play with this. But I go with the Feezy. I might do like a street view or something. Let's just, you know, whatever's going on here, I don't know. But with the Feezy. What the fizzy, you know? Just having to what the fizzy moment. What the fizzy is this? Portal? Anybody portal? Managa. Managa. What the fees is this? Whoa. See, here you can see a little depth to it. It's not sticking up, it's going inward, right? It's like more, you know what I mean? Like a black hole type of sinkhole, but what the fizzy? What's the green? What's the blue? Imagine this thing in real time. It's gonna get more, you know, interesting, won't you? Just playing with Google Earth, saying what the fizzy. What's going on? Let's just meditate and find some weird stuff in the desert. You know, we don't do this enough, you know, meditating. Find some weird things at the same damn time. So fall back with a knife. Get some vibes going, man. What the fizzy? Wow. Okay, okay, okay. Like I said, I'm not here to guess. I'm gonna say this don't look completely just natural, you know. There's some asymmetrics, you know, symmetric, however you want to say it, you know, formation going on here. This is clearly a design. It seems to be going inward. And I don't know what all these little star-like situations are. But I'm not going to take it lightly because I don't see them anywhere else in this desert. Seems to be the only stars I can find in the desert. I mean, come on, Managa. What the feezy are we seeing here? And here's where it gets strange. If that wasn't strange. Here's where it gets strange. Let's go back to the 2D map a little bit. Yeah, look at these little star-like things. Oh, bro. Come on, bro. Gotcha. Okay. Star-like things is all I can say. Star-like things in the desert. Maybe we'll call this drop star-like things in the desert. Because I can't say there's stars, quasars. I can't say what this is. But it looks like a star. It's star-like things in the desert, man. Got everybody asking what the fees. I need all this. Alright, my cons. Alright, maybe I'm tripping. Maybe drop over drop. And I said this is just, you know, in across the drop desk. All the drop y'all send me, I appreciate y'all, man. Hey, after the cons. Whether it's the DMs that I barely get in, man, on the IG, I'm sorry, man, or the emails, you know what I mean? I just really appreciate y'all, because whenever I need it, it's there. Whether it's on Discord, man, Copper Thread, shout out to Copper Thread, Eat the Squad, dropping that drop. Everybody dropping that drop. I appreciate you, all your comments. Yeah, so there's a bunch of stuff. All right, let's have some fun. All right, let me stop playing. First of all right, yeah, some type of weird boat. So maybe they can go in the water, push the boat through. I don't know. Is it water? Maybe it's just water. You know, with a bunch of star-like things. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. Y'all tell me. Is it just water with some star-like stuff in it? Is it just a reflection? Is this just a reservoir? Drop stripping. I've been over dropping. I can admit sometimes I be over dropping. You tell me. I ask you to tell me. Star-like things in a desert, boss. That's a great one. What a boat. What is a boat doing in a damn desert? I mean, this is desert, boss. Star-like things. I said things. Things and stuff, I see. I'm not, this is desert. This is Cali desert. You know what I'm saying? You see any more portals around here, Bo? I mean, I see some, you know, I see a lot of strangeness, you know, for sure. But star-like thing? You see some star-like thing? I I mean, I see little lakes, you know, Death Valley's right here, okay. So it's kind of near Death Valley. Death Valley, okay. Telescope Peak. Okay. Got the Indian Springs over there, all right. Coastal California, all right, all right. 15, interesting. Oh, God, turned around. That's where the 15 would go. You take the 15 all the way to Vegas, man. All the way to Vegas. But now I see some lakes and rivers and different things, but star-like things in the desert? Nah, man. Seems to be pretty unique. I'm gonna play Mark way out here. Oh, where'd it go? My bad. I'm dropping right now. I'm moving too fast. Even this is weird, you know. All this. Don't let me get Mud Fossil. Mud Fossil. Shout out to Mud Fossil University, man. You're gonna see all kind of dragons and giant fish, giants, different, you know, all kind of stuff. Alright, alright. Where's my okay. Let me slow down. I was too excited. Just got too excited. I'm just saying, I don't do this often. But with a dragonfly perspective, you start seeing a lot of strangeness. And, you know, you have your viewpoint, walking around every day, driving around, like that's a viewpoint, right? But the perspective along with your dragonfly perspective, you know, you start to see the earth in more complexity, as always saying. Gold points, silver peak, goodness gracious. Yeah, I got place marks all over the place. One is way out here. I mean, away from the star-like things. You know, but let's see what this is. Look how it's connected to this little area. I don't know if I checked this out. It's an interesting area right there. Ah, yeah, Hawaii. That's right. Now I remember. I was digging on Hawaii, and they said this was this reservoir, this Hawaii reservoir. Hawaii. And this got me just digging on the reservoir system, the LA aqueduct. I mean, just dig on the aqueduct system, all the people that died trying to make this thing. You know, they went from the Owens River initially, then they took the Colorado, you know, flow. So with California, all this stuff is desert. I don't know if it's always been, obviously. Flooding and all that, right? But yeah, this how we cool, you know. It's here. Just had an interesting formation to it, first of all, man. Water dragony, you know, water dragony. you know, but yeah, this was rare to see this water just popping up in this desert way out here. And then to hear that it's a reservoir, you know, that they, you know, either flooded some town that was here a long time ago, you know how it goes, man. Naga cities. Underwater, so yeah, South Hawaii Reservoir. Yeah, we gotta dig on that. That's why I place marked that spot. But let's get back to the star-like things in the desert. I bet it's beautiful though. I can tell, man. But that water is pure water. That water. The Drakov. Like a water dragon over here. I mean, it's just so much strangeness. Just so much strangeness. Just like out of placeness, and you know, they building their developments. And you can see this whole circle. Sometimes you can see like all these like almost Nazca lines. You know what I'm saying? From this dragonfly perspective, look at this like concentric circle situation right here. Like, is that natural? You kind of start seeing more like little designs, Nazca lines. Some are paved roads, well, not dirt roads, but look at this concentric circle, though. Just, you know, it's just an interesting thing in the desert. California desert's pretty strange, man. I will say that. And it's like a circle and a square flow, huh? What's this, man? I got a book. I got a place marked this, man. More high strangeness. More high strangeness. Bang. Yeah, I guess he could have done it with whatever equipment, but imagine how massive this is if it's just popping up, you know, from that aerial view to make a perfect circle that large. Golly, golly. And a square, too. And some is faded, some ain't. This is just an interesting little stuff, man. It is what it is. It's just strange, that's all. High strangeness in the desert, man. I'm looking back to this. What is this? Perfect circles. Look how many. Could just be some agricultural field. That's pretty amazing. Okay. Trying to get as close as I can. Alright, this is a water joint. Maybe they got the crops going. Okay. Interesting. They got it popping. Like strangers in the desert. We're just finding stuff. Could be something, could be nothing. Massive agricultural field, I guess. Okay. I mean, just ping pong. Maybe they use that to feed whatever city they about to pop off. I see a lot of agriculture here. Now, Trending Truth, man, said that there was a bunch of tanks around that star-like situation. Owens Lake. Yes. I believe this is the lake. Right. This is where they were initially getting the water to get to California. And then something happened, some disaster. And they switched it up to the Colorado River, I think. So, interesting story. Because they use a lot of indigenous knowledge to do that. Mua Mountain. Okay, Templeton Mountain. Let's get it. High strangers. We're going back in. Alright, so let's look for these tanks. Patient with my internet, it's not the fastest, y'all, but you know, we got the music playing, so the vibe is always right. Beautiful mountains, you know, a lot of different colors. You know, are they mountains, mud fossil? What is this, man? It says Little Petroglyph Canyon. So you know we're talking dragons. All right, let's have some fun. I got all kind of stuff happening over here, man. Where's the high strangers? Everywhere, John. Everywhere. Hey, did they blur this out or something? They ain't gonna give me nothing. No. Whoa. There we go. Hold on. Wait. So they want me to see something over here, man. Remember we were looking into the rivers and the oceans? Where Naga City's underwater and all this blurred out stuff that they did. They don't want us to see certain things on the satellite. Wow. I mean, I put a place mark here for something. I wouldn't be surprised if they had some type of algorithm every time we put a place mark. It does some type of alert so that they say, uh-oh, there's another place mark. They get some type of ping. Every time somebody puts a place mark somewhere, I gotta stop using place marks. so that they don't know where I'm looking, because then they know exactly where you're looking. And you signed into it, so they know who's looking. They say, why is this person pinging me right now? Then next thing you know, they blur it out. Ain't that something? All right, you go back. I act like I'm tripping. Why it's so blurry? Okay. Well, I do see a tank over here. Why is there a tank over here? See that tank? It looks like a fish. Maybe that's why I placed Mark the Gus off tank. Let's see if we can find some more tanks. Because I'm around that star-like portal. Star-like things in the desert. Let's go in. Going tank watching. You see things, you know, that's just very strange, man. High strange. This little city set up, little stretches of grain out of nowhere. All these places, right? This is all around the, you know, star-like portal I'm about to get back to. I'm just saying. Let's show you what's around it. Yeah, I mean, like, what's this? What is this? We'll come back to it. High strangeness in the desert. Let's get it. Let's pull up into the star. Yeah, that's where NASA goes. star-like things. What is this, man? What's going on here? Oh, this is like a craft almost, man. Some type of Star Wars situation. Are there any tanks nearby here? Let's see. Let's check around, man. Let's check our six. I heard this thing was heavily guarded, but like at a distance, it wasn't, you know, not too close on it, but they was all around us. So let's check it out. Okay. So nearby, this little entrance here, you start seeing this cluster of tank formations, and all these are tanks. Let's go in. Let's go in. You see what I see, but not. Shh, quiet. Do y'all see what I see, boss? What's up with these tanks, right? What's up with all these tanks? Things, stuff. What are these tanks doing around here? Just meditating? What's going on? No, what are these tanks doing out here? For real. We're in the middle of nowhere, right? California desert. They're just testing the artillery near the portal, boss. Are they waiting, you know, against whatever's coming out the portal? Or is it just nothing? Just tank heaven, you know, like a tank of, like bumper cars. Maybe they're just playing bumper cars. Man, I'm overdriving. They just out here playing tank bumper cars near some type of star-like stuff. In the open desert, man, right? right, boss? Ain't nothing to see here, boss. Ain't nothing to see here, boss. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ain't nothing to see here, boss. Maybe this is like a No Limit concert. You know, Master P, we got the tank army, man. You know, tank salute. Maybe it's a No Limit party, man. Master P, what it do, man? Hey, man, I don't really look, man. All right. What is this, like a car auction, man? What? All these are tanks. 1, 2, 3, 4. All these are tanks, all right? Okay. Birdman Henry. Just digging on these dirt trails. Yeah. All right. So they got a whole bunch of tanks just chilling near this entrance to this thing. We got something buried here, whatever is going on here. You know, can't tell if this is going up or down. Looks like a mound of some type. You know, circular mound, I don't know. Something definitely seems inside of it. What the feezy? The feezy, man. So, you know, came across a drop desk. I had to drop it on y'all. Ask y'all for help. Identify. It could be something y'all could say, hey, nah, man. Oh, man. Hey, man, this could be somebody's new mansion, man, you know. Hey, man. Could be somebody's dream house. Got they boat. Alright, so you got all these tanks around. All these little areas are all this tank business. So you roll up, you see all these tanks, you're like, what the feezy? It's just tanks everywhere. Ready to bomb or blast something, right? I mean, that's what tanks do. Last time I checked, be blasting stuff, you know, blasting stuff. I don't know, Bo. I'm gonna leave it on y'all, you know, solve this mystery. This is also an interesting little mountain range development here. Mud fossil, get on this, man. Get on it. Come on, boss. Don't tell me this ain't shit. Don't tell me this is nothing. Can't tell me this is nothing. It clearly looks like the Aurora Borealis going within the earth, man. All right? Big Savage, let him know, man. You just gonna gloss over this? You gonna gloss over artistic interpretation? This thing must be massive. Man, what is going on? High strangeness in the desert. Tanks, portals. California. Let's go. I say the California frequency is, you know, still connected with that muon. You know, that Mount Shasta flow, you know, still connected with Lemuria. What if they feel like they can, you know, still connect to those places, you know? Yeah, and just to check out a couple more place marks we got. Let's see. Go through these one by one as we make our dismount. A lot of them I forgot what I saw, but I saw something that made me say, what the feezy? Okay. Okay, my dog, say it with me. We're in the high desert, nothing around. You see something like this pop up. The portal's nearby, just remember that. Let this render take its time. Get too excited. Start moving too fast. Yeah, my love. I'm trying to get the view going. This thing keeps getting stuck. There we go. Turn this thing around. What the fizzy, man. Okay, I mean, it could be like a Jedi fighter situation. Maybe a paper airplane, I don't know. Let's see some more. Oh, there we go. Okay. All right, what else we got? What else we got? Loaded, so they took all my little place points away. That's all good, because you know we can still search this thing though. We're gonna find some stuff together. That's all that means. I'm just checking them out over here. That's all. Just checking them out. We're playing, so that means we're gonna find some more things. Is this a tank over here too, man? Another tank. Look at this. Look at this. What's these tanks doing next to this situation? Come on, man. It's like the Aurora Borealis. Aurora, you know what I'm saying? It's like a nebula, man. Come on, boss. Come on, boss. This ain't no random natural thing. I mean, it could be natural, but I don't, you know. I don't drop nation out. I need y'all. I need y'all on this one. Right. Hey, Mother Fossil, we need you on this one, man. Because this definitely has some type of a Mother Fossil vibe over here. And, you know, if you pay attention, you see these lines kind of, you know, start doing some type of designs and different things that do remind me of the Nazca Flow. Certain locations. I mean, I think we've seen enough to at least let Drop Nation pop off. Y'all let me know what y'all digging on. What's happening out here in this high desert? We know a lot's happening in Arizona, right? Sedona, Flagstaff, Scottsdale. Now we know Arizona's a hot spot. We know New Mexico's a hot spot for sure. Just with a dragonfly perspective, we're just cruising through the so-called desert that wasn't always a desert. You know what I mean? It wasn't always a desert. some type of like waste. Waste site, you know. Oh man. Crazy talk happening. This little area here is, you know, pretty freaky too, man. I mean, come on, man. You know, from a bird's eye view. This is an interesting little design going on. Almost like it was a giant tree stump, huh? Almost like a giant tree stump and a cut off tree stump. See so much different texture there. You see the outline of it. All right. We got our work cut out for us. Guess the investigation continues. That's all I'm gonna say. Things that make you go, huh? Oh, that's right. Yeah, my other pins should be saved. So I can find those later. I'm just learning some Google Earth stuff, man, for next time. Okay. Still got some place marks here. Okay. Hey, we found some work. I thought I lost y'all, man. Thought you was gone. Cool. So we take the 5 to the 15 through Vegas, you know what I'm saying, go towards Utah, through Arizona, cut to New Mexico, Colorado, and you'd be passing right through this high strength. That's all I could call it, star-like stuff. Let's see what this one is. Let's vibe with a noggin. Take a ride with a noggin. Check out these place marks for the dismount. Is that the, which one is this? Okay, we saw that one. We saw that one. Mud Fossil, take the wheel. Oh, that's the moon we just did. Okay, gotcha. Let's go into it then. There might just be more tanks. There's another one of those circles. There we go. More tanks. More tanks. Some of these look like they're about to be portals and pop up, man. Just keeping an eye on them, like watching the development of the portals or something. Let's get it like this. I think I'm just looking at the... bird's eye view of the designs on the ground. I'm trying to see if any of these designs look interesting. I mean, obviously some tire marks, this, that, but oh boy. Which way did he go? Little lake, they call it. So many trails, right? So much stuff, man. All across the earth plane, you know, especially over here, south, southwest. Man, this is so much to uncover. So much strangeness. I'm sure you see your own set of strangeness. So you let me know what type of strangeness you find in, man. I'll add it to my strangeness. Have a strange time together. Thank you. I mean, it's just strange. It's like a portal to be. Strange, man. Strange stuff. It's a random patch of green. Letting you know that there's still that water flowing. If this could be some random patch of green, that means all this used to be green, man. All this used to be some beautiful forest, you know. Before the water had to recede, like the Anasazi migration. Say between 900 and 1200, 1300 Anasazi migrations, man. Love to the Haka, man. Back to Tenochtitlan, right? All right, cuz, I mean, you got it. You got it from here. Y'all got it from here, man. Right. It's too real for me. It's too real to fit. I'm trying to see what these things are outside of here. Some type of tell me, just a big ass boat. Come on, boss. Come on, boss. What is this doing in the desert, boss? It's some type of a Montauk project, man. Boats just appearing and going through the portal. Coming out the portal. Star-like thing. Yeah, man. I appreciate y'all taking this ride in this high strangeness with a knot. If I didn't have y'all to, you know, ride with a knot, ride with a knot, ride with a con, I'd be riding alone. In the world of high strangeness and strange things. In a whole nother universe. Star-like things in the desert. Wow. Okay, guys. Okay. All right. I guess they're ready for it, right? They're ready on call. They're ready. They're ready, boss. Oh, yeah. Guess they're ready out here. Guess they ready out here, boss. It's all happening. It's all happening. Guess they ready out here, boss. Guess they really ready. Stay really ready. Get ready for whatever. Whatever's coming. Through star-like things. In the open desert. Well, we keep the cold. No power before our power. No vanity on Allah's name, Allah, which is your breath when you walk through the door. Strong power enters your family. You gather, you walk, you move through an entrance. You got the revelation, that look, that breath. You got that security. You got your food, your nourishment. That's the first seven letters of the Ibaru. Strong power enters your tent, floor plan. You start to move, check, through a door. Big Mama says, gives you that revelation. Abba gives you the foundation, the tent peg, to secure the tent floor plan. So you can eat, my naga, and cut off that hijack. Put that hijack outside so you know what's inside your wall. Was surrounding your basket so you know how to worship, how to work, my night. Strong power. Ha, wa, sa, when you walk through the door. Don't take that in vain. Remember your Shabbat. 6 days you work, 7 day we rest. Honor your framer and your shaper always. Father, your mother, don't murder your brother, your sister. Don't keep your oaths, man. No adultery with your cons, man. Don't steal from your cons. Don't bear false witness on your cons. Don't covet no more jealousy in your heart ball. La wa. Wow. And Moses called unto Israel, Deuteronomy chapter 5, and said to them, O Israel, hear the statutes and ordinances which I speak in your ears this day, that you may learn them and observe to do them. Allah, our power, made a covenant with us in Horeb. Allah made not this covenant with our fathers, but with us, even us, who are all of us here alive this day. Allah spoke with you face to face in the mount of the mist of fire. I stood between Allah and you at that time to declare unto you the word of Allah, for you were afraid because of the fire and went not up into the mount, saying, I am Allah, your power. You were afraid of because of the fire. Moshe went up to the mountain. We went not up into the mountain. But Moshe went up that mountain for a Naga, man. I am Allah, your power, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before. Let's start right there, right? Let's just start right there. Because it always starts right there. With your strong power being established. That's always the beginning. Who is your power? Who is your power? Allah says, no power before me. No other gods. I am your power. I am your leader. I am your strength. Read Psalms 18. David prays to Allah. You are my rock. You are my refuge. You are my strength. That's where the game begins. It begins or ends with you being plugged in directly to your source, your power, your leader, so it can enter your house, your family, your ruach, your tribe. The earth, my Nadi, so that we can gather, move together through this entrance, man, and have this revelation together, have this breath together, and get our security so we can eat together. But it starts with no other power before me. So no matter what hijack city's popping off with, and their portals and their CERNs and their ARPs, we remember, man, it's all in our favor. It's all in your favor, Khan, because you already got it, Khan. Say it with me. I already got it, Khan. One more time. I already got it, Khan. Allah, Tribe Up, Drop Nation.